Hi, my name is Lafaya Mitchell, licensed marriage and family therapist. If you tuned in last time, I went over kind of an overview of what the Lafaya Way is and the core four concepts within the Lafaya Way. So today, I'm going to break down concept number one. So number one is find your calm. I use the word find on purpose because most people do not have it, okay? And they don't know where it is. There are many, many ways to figure out how to find your calm. And one of the first ways to do that is to take care of yourself. If personal self-care, personal growth work is like number one. It's really difficult to be calm when you are not centered, when you are not eating well, when you're not feeling well. There's a concept within the, I think Alcoholics Anonymous, they use H.A.L.T. And it's an acronym for, you know, really being able to tune into what's going on with you or others. It's hungry, angry, lonely, tired. It's a check-in. So are you hungry? Are you angry? Were you already having a bad day in the first place? Or lonely? You know what I mean by lonely? Like you're feeling unsupported, and even if there are other people around you, you're still feeling kind of on your own or by yourself. And for kids, a lot of times this is they're bored. They don't say they're lonely. Maybe some kids might use that word, but most of the time you'll hear bored and tired. Yeah, if you're not getting enough rest, and you're not gonna feel well. That's just automatic. Like, people can say what they want to say, but spend enough time without rest and you will not be a happy person. You will be a cranky person. And so really, self-care is number one there. A second piece is avoid personalizing the behaviors that you're getting out of your child. Keep in mind that your child's not waking up in the morning thinking, oh yeah, I'm gonna irritate as many people as possible because that's the joy I get in life. Nobody's waking up thinking that. Just remember that when they're doing things that are annoying, even if at the time it feels like they're being annoying on purpose and all that, internally, like deep down inside, at their core, they don't want to be disliked. Okay, nobody wants to be disliked. Even if they say they don't care and that they want to be disliked, it's not true, because eventually you'll have them saying that they're sad because they're not liked. And that kind of, actually, I kind of moved into understand the real reasons behind the behavior a little bit. When there is acting out behavior, then you have to understand what's really going on. It's not just that they're acting out. What's really happening is they may lack the self-esteem that it takes to present themselves as a likable person. Maybe they don't feel likable. Sorry, I'm not really trying to get into blaming for the parents here, but it has a lot to do with you. If you don't like your kid, it's hard for your kid to feel liked. Like, if your own parent can't like you, there's a problem there. Like your parents are supposed to like you. So if they don't like you, then how are other people gonna like you? Right? Understand the real truth behind the behavior. When there's that lack of self-esteem for whatever reason, okay, then there's a lack of ability to really perform as your optimal person, okay? And so once we start to build that self-esteem, we start to increase the feelings of, you know, being liked and all that, then you'll find there are a lot less behaviors. Those are my top three to make sure you're taking a look at. Lastly, I'm gonna give you the reason why it's important to find your calm. First of all, it's because it's really hard on your body not to be calm. You know, stress doesn't do great things for us, and stress also doesn't cause us to have the best reactions, or the reactions that are going to get us the best results out of our kids. That's just one piece. But another piece is hypersensitive children tend to do this thing that I call emotion soaking. They take on that feeling energy of those around them. So if you are very upset, if you're very agitated, frustrated, all those things, then a kid will start to, they'll draw from that. If they're already upset, which usually they are, they're already upset, then it just kind of compounds the problem. They don't have something to grab a hold of that can help them find their calm. So you want to be that model of calm so that they can follow that. That's my discussion. And I mean, I could really talk about it, I think, all day long. I'm finding your calm. I won't do that to you. I'll just refer you to my book, The Lafaya Way. You can purchase that. You can find that on barnesandnoble.com. or on amazon.com. So that's all I have for you for today. Until next time, stay you and stay true.